So first I'll tell you what is addressing modes. It is the CPU which is going to address it, which is going to reach the data, how it is going to access the data from one memory location to another memory location. We have a read and write operations in a CPU. Okay, so this how it is going to access the data from the memory location or reach to the memory. That is the concept of addressing modes. It has various ways to access the memory registers from one location to another location. So in this various ways, these are all the main seven different ways which we are going to access the data. Okay, so through the register addressing mode, register type, we are accessing the data. Immediate addressing mode, we are accessing the data. Direct addressing modes, register indirect addressing modes, base register addressing modes, index register addressing modes, base index relative addressing modes we have. So we'll see one by one how the data is going to be accessed from one memory location to another. Okay, so for example, first one will take a register addressing mode. The example I'm going to take with the instruction move. Okay, so move is the instruction which will copy the data from one location to another location. So move AX comma BX. This is assembly language. We all know that this assembly language instruction. Through this assembly language instruction only, we are going to execute the programs and everything in our lab and all those things. So here from the register BX to the register AX, we are going to copy the data. Okay, so the data will be copied from one memory location to another memory location. So here the data is present, whatever the data present in the BX, that will be copied into AX. Okay, so here the data is present in terms of the registers, so it is called as register addressing mode. The data which we are going to copy from the register to another register. So for example, you can able to have so many instructions, so many other instructions like AL comma BL, SI comma DI. These are all the different ways of register addressing mode examples. So here what is this AL? This is the 8-bit register. So we have the registers, we have registers like AX, BX, CX, DX. Is the general purpose registers which will store the data. General purpose registers which will store the data. So like that we have many registers. This is of 16-bit information it can able to store. So like that we have AL, BL, CL, DL, AH, BH, CH and DH. These are all your 8-bit registers. So through these registers, we are going to copy the data from one location to another location. That is called as register addressing mode. Okay. So what if the data we are passing immediately from one location to another location, then that is called as immediate addressing mode. Example, move AX comma 23. So here I am copying the data 23 directly to the address, to the register, directly to the register, AL comma 00001, BX comma 3F56. This is a hexadecimal number, so it has to be represented with H. If you are not representing any with the characters, then it will take it as a binary or it will take it as a decimal. Okay, so here you can see directly the numbers, directly the data and copying to the another registers. So it is called as immediate way of copying the data, immediate way of addressing accessing the data from one location to the another location. Okay, and direct addressing mode. Example, third one, example 3. So direct addressing mode here, from the memory location, we are going to copy the content to the register. registers. From the memory location, we are going to copy the content to the registers. So here we have given in the BX some data will be there that will be copied into the another register. Here directly a data we are giving that will be copied into another register. That is immediate. Here it has to fetch, it has to go to the 2000 memory location. There some data will be there, 10, 11, 12 or A, B, C, D, some data will be there. That data will be fetched and it will be copied to AX. So that is called as direct addressing mode. So it will go to the particular memory location, 2000 is the memory location, and there where whatever the data is there, that will be copied. So that is called as direct addressing mode. Register indirect addressing mode, the same thing. If you are giving the address in terms of register, then it is called as register addressing mode. Say for example, this 2000, I am going to give it as BX. So BX is going to have the value of BX is some address. Okay, that address, in that address, whatever the data, that will be copied to the AX. That is the meaning. So here the address, the data we are giving in terms of address, the data we are giving in terms of registers. So it is called as register indirect addressing mode. Okay. And base register, the same thing, I'll rub it this one. So base register addressing mode, index register addressing mode. So here we have the base registers are BX and BP. There are two types of base registers. Index registers, again there are two types of index registers, SI and DX. Source index, destination index. BX is your base register and BP is base pointer register. So we have two types. So if you are using this type of addressing modes for representing a location, or an address, from the address the data will be fetched and copied to the another register. So if you are representing the base register for representing a location and the data will be copied to AX, then it is called as base index addressing, base register addressing mode. If you are using source index or destination index, index registers if you are using to represent the location, then it will be called as index register addressing mode. Okay. So if you are using base registers, then it is called as base register addressing mode. If you are using index, then it is called as index register addressing mode. So here what it represents, usually we have four different types of the memory is divided into four segments, which is data segment, code segment, stack segment and extra segment. So each and every segments is called, this is the whole memory of your processor, microprocessor. So this will be represented by default BX, DI, SI. This will be represented by IP as register. And this will be represented by BP and SP register. This will be represented by BX, DI, SI. So what is the meaning here? If we are giving the location address in terms of BX, it will automatically go to the data segment memory and it will copy the data in the data segment memory. That will be copied to AX. That's the meaning. So if you are giving BP, by default BP means it will go to stack. segment. So in the stack segment, whatever the data, that will be copied to AX. So that particular location data will be copied. So suppose the location of SI is SI, the value of SI is 2000 or 1000, the value of SI is 1000, it will go to the, by default the segment will be accessed as SI. In SI segment it will go to 1000 location. In 1000 location, what is the data over here? Suppose 00 and 01, these two data will be fetched and copied to the AX register. This is how it will be working. So if you are having a DI register, that it will be fetching. Suppose the DI register is 2000. So what is the default segment for DI register? There are two segments which will access the default DI registers. So if you give the DI register, it can able to access data segment, it can able to access extra segment also. So if how, so which it will be accessing, there will be a confusion. So if there is a normal move instruction or normal addition or subtraction instruction, logical instruction, arithmetic instruction, it will be by default it will be directly going and fetching the data from the data segment. If you are having the string operations, so there are different kind of instructions out there. This is normal instruction and this is string instruction, move string. If followed by S, then it is called a string instruction. If the instruction is string operation, then it will go to extra segment, or otherwise it will go to data segment. So this DI and SI and BX will access two segments. So there will be a confusion which segment to access. So this normal operation means it will go to data segment. If it is string operation means it will go to extra segment. So this is how the process, the data will be accessed from one memory location, and that will be copied to any memory location. Okay. So both if I want to use, then it is called as base index addressing mode. So suppose if you are using move, example add also you can take, any instruction you can take, all instructions are called as data accessing registers. So here I am using move AX comma BX plus SI plus 10. Okay. So it will take the, it will reach the, first it has to calculate the address, then it has to reach the particular memory location, and then it has to fetch the data that will be copied to AX. This is the meaning. So for example, BX is 1000, it will add 1000 plus SI is 2000, then 2000. We have given the displacement value. This is called as displacement value, which means that you have 100 locations of arrays. In that, which data I want to copy or access, that is called as displacement value. So this is 1000 plus 2000 plus 10, whatever the value, 3010 will be there. This is the total memory location calculated. To which segment it will be accessing, since we are using BX and SI. If you are using BX and SI, it will go to data segment. So in the data segment, 3010th location, whatever the data we have, that will be copied to AX. This is the meaning. So this is how the data will be accessed. So there are 7 different modes, major mode to access the data from one place to another place. This is applicable for all the instruction, not only for the move instruction, for the add instruction, subtract or logical instruction, you can able to apply. So this addressing mode is a concept of accessing a data from one place to another place.